Hello. My name is James Dowdell. I'm currently a New York City firefighter assigned to Rescue Company 2. Thank you. I joined the FDNY in January 2006, following in the footsteps of my father, Kevin Dowdell, who was Lieutenant in Rescue 4 and one of 343 firemen killed on September 11, 2001. If you asked me on September 10th to describe my life, I would have to say it was perfect. I grew up in Breezy Point, New York, in a house my father built with his bare hands. My older brother Patrick was my best friend, and my parents had a relationship that to this day I strive for with my wife. My mother and father worked extremely hard putting my brother and I through Xavier High School. My father went from the firehouse to a side job installing hardwood floors, and my mother was a public school teacher in Brooklyn. In 2001, I was a 17-year-old senior in high school. My brother was an 18-year-old freshman in college. My father had over 20 years in the fire department at that point, and he and my mother are finally approaching and looking forward to a retirement in the near future. Then in an instant, it all changed. The time for them to finally take it easy, travel, and enjoy their hard-earned retirement disappeared, and our family was devastated. I vividly remember the days following 9/11, where every time the door opened, there was a hope that my father would come walking in. Like many other families, we held on to that hope that there was a chance that he made it out okay. Finally, we had to face the grim reality that he was gone. In the months following September 11th, everyone came together to begin the difficult task of recovering the bodies of those who were lost that day. My father's firehouse, Rescue 4, worked tirelessly to recover the 9 members that they lost. We waited until there was nothing else to search through, but his body was never found. We held his funeral on April 20th, 2002, 7 months after 9/11. It's not something that anyone plans for. We all understand the dangers associated with the job. But when a fireman or a policeman walks out the door to go to work, we always assume and hope that they'll come home at the end of that tour. No one wants to think about the worst happening, but we all recognize the dangers associated with our respective services. Although we are well aware of these dangers, I still felt the desire to join the FDNY. I grew up with the values that go hand in hand with the service of others. It drove me to become a fireman. It drove my brother Patrick to go to West Point, have combat deployments in both Iraq and Afghanistan. Helping others is a reward. Thank you. Helping others is a reward in itself. Answer the Call carries these exact same values for the work they do with the families who are willing to sacrifice themselves to others. While coping with the tragic loss of my father, my mother also had to keep up with the bills and other everyday tasks that comes along with raising 2 teenage boys. On September 12th, the bills were still due. That's where Answer the Call came in. This fund helps families like mine in the hardest time of our lives, get immediate financial support so that life can actually continue. Beyond that, events held throughout the year, the family baseball game, soiree, nights like tonight, the gala, also remind us that even these years later, our family's not forgotten. Now that I am on the job and in the shoes my father was in, I am grateful to know that Answer the Call is there should the worst happen. And it's because of all people like you that one thing can be taken off the list of worries that a widow and their families have to worry about. You are not simply just giving money. You're giving families like mine in our darkest hour a hand. And speaking from personal experience, that really is priceless. I can honestly say there is a comfort in what we do, knowing that people like you are all out there and support us and are willing to take care of our families. So thank you for your support. Thank you to Answer the Call for the work you've done and that you continue to do. Thank you. Many other children of fallen firefighters, police officers, and EMTs have decided to follow in their heroic parents' footsteps and wear the uniform. We are honored to have a few of them here with us tonight, and I ask you that you join me in welcoming them on stage.
On behalf of everyone in the room, we thank these brave men and women for their service.